Jnanam paramam dheyam. Knowledge is supreme.
Hello and welcome to this course, Fundamentals of Power Electronics. I am Vivek Agarwal and I am a faculty in the Department of Electrical Engineering at IIT Bombay in Mumbai. Now, what is power electronics? Power electronics deals with the conversion of power through electronics means. Power electronics achieves the power conversion through a power converter. Now, what is a power converter? It is nothing but, you know, we can, in the simplest form, we can say that it is a matrix of electronic switches. And apart from the switches, it uses certain passive elements like inductors and capacitors. So all of these actually constitute a power electronic circuit. The switch matrix, the matrix of the switches, is controlled in such a way that, you know, you get the desired output from your power electronic circuit. The need for power electronics has been felt for a long time. In fact, right from the time the electricity was invented. In the earlier days, power electronics was implemented using rotary converters and, you know, devices like mercury arc rectifiers. Later, in the 20th century, around 1950s or 60s, the advent of power semiconductor devices like the power diodes and the SCR, the silicon controlled rectifier, completely revolutionized the field of power electronics. Today, whatever power electronics we see around us, it is all based on the solid state electronics technology, which was developed in 1950s and 1960s, and which continues to evolve to this day. Now, power electronics has become a very popular field. In fact, we see power electronics in all spheres of our lives. It is everywhere, whether it is a home appliance like a refrigerator or the air conditioner, or, you know, whether it's an electric train in which we are trying to go from one place to another, or whether we are talking about certain defense systems like a ballistic missile, a fighter aircraft, or we're talking about an aircraft carrier. None of these is possible without power electronics. So basically, power electronics is everywhere and indispensable. Now, in this course, we will be covering a wide range. So basically, the idea is that even a beginner should be able to benefit from the course. We wish to cover the basic power converter configurations, which will involve the conversion of power from AC to DC, DC to DC, DC to AC, and AC to AC forms. We would try to cover all the relevant control schemes which are applicable to these converters, as well as we will also see certain specialized configurations of these power converter schemes. We also plan to cover the various power semiconductor devices, their architecture, their working, and their characteristics, so as to enable, you know, a participant to be able to use them in case of implementing power electronics for a certain application. We will also cover certain practical aspects of power electronics, such as the snubbers, the drive circuits, and the heat sinking. We also want to cover several popular applications of power electronics. For example, the application of power electronics to renewable energy conversion, to power quality enhancement, and so on. We would also strive to cover the advancements in power semiconductor technology, such as the arrival and the use of wide bandgap devices, such as the silicon carbide and the gallium nitride devices, which can operate at high frequencies without incurring much losses. We expect this course to be useful to the undergraduate students who are doing regular power electronic courses in various universities and institutes. I also expect this particular course to be beneficial to the postgraduate students, including the researchers who are engaged in research on power electronics. I also expect the industry professionals and the researchers who are involved with power electronics research at the various R&D organizations to benefit from this course. Overall, I feel that this is going to be a course that would be useful to a wide range of audience. I invite you to participate in this course. Thank you.